that's when you start to not grow anymore. You just have to chase that L, chase that L. So you know if like you really, really, really want something and then you fail at it, you're embarrassed, you're probably on the right track. And that's where you need to like, you need to get real, real, real comfortable with that feeling. Just like being in that like slightly embarrassing zone where like you call your parents and you're like, you don't really want to tell them what's going on in your life. Like that type of embarrassment, that's what makes you great, bro. Cause then you start to get like, man, I'm gonna read everything. I'm gonna study everything. Nobody can poke holes in this. And you try to create, and it's like, it's motivated by that at first, and then it starts to become like, damn, like I can actually change people's lives like this. Where we at, Steph?
10 seconds.
So I think people, like a lot of times people think it's like you do a lot of work at once, and then like you live on that work, but it's more just like a consistent effort of like a daily habit of like doing a little bit on each thing. So like what I realized is like what you schedule and what you put in your schedule is what you actually end up doing. So if you schedule time to like program or schedule time to go like a deep dive on things, then you'll actually will go deep, even if it's like a 45-minute block, like you'll go deep on it.
Understand?
It's complex.
Yeah.
But now I can like very simply explain things that might have been more difficult.
Right.
And then there's obviously levels above that because you have Dan Pfaff and these great minds that are 35 steps ahead of us right now. Yeah. But like I think the biggest key to this really, like, and this is probably the most important thing out of everything I said, is that we're not afraid to fail.
A lot of athletes think they should just walk into something and succeed the first time. And they have this perception like they should be the best from the minute they start. So they're afraid to fail. And you see those athletes just not ever really make it past the level they're at. And the athletes that make it, they're making it because they don't really care what people think. And when they fail, they're not really concerned what the perception is of their failure. They're just trying to figure out, how do I get better from it?
This is how we're supposed to do every day. Don't tap out of this. Work like this every single day. Work on three. One, two, three. One.
My granny 88, she had my uncle in there. A miscarriage back to back every year.
I used to do everything on my own, where I was like, just trying to do everything, the stretching, the weights, the speed. And then I was like, yo, Dill, I'm fucking tired, bro. Like, I need you. And I let Dylan step in. Then I was like, dang, like, Dylan has, like, the energy, he's got the presence. Like, man, he's like, it's like, we're doing the same thing. So then you start to trust people, and they start to do it on their own, you know? The drills are the same this week. We're gonna switch them next week, so AWOP. March, switch with the stick, switch with the bounce, triple with the stick and triple with the bounce. Then we have 4x5 yard starts over there and 3x10.
Dylan.
Okay, then next, go down more.
Nah.
Okay,
so 2016, I was working for USA Rugby, making $0 a month. And I was working with them. It was right before, it was after the Olympics or before the Olympics? It was after.
November after.
So it was right after the Olympics. I have no job, don't know what I'm doing. And I do a USA Rugby clinic. And like 15 people showed up, and it was in Chicago. Dylan was one of those 15 people. It was like $75. It was out in the middle of nowhere, super random. Dylan pulls up, he goes through the whole clinic. Afterwards, he's like, hey, I want to intern for you. I'm like, I'm shocked. I never had an intern in my entire life. Like, how could I have an intern? I make $0 a month. It makes no sense. So Dylan pulls up, he's like, hey, can I intern? I was like, absolutely. You know, the way I am, I'll just always say yes, but I didn't know if he was serious or not. So afterwards, we're walking away. He's like, hey, it cost me like $60 to Uber here. So can I just ride with you back? I was like, yeah, come on. So he rode with me back, we just chopped it up. That was November. In December, he got in his car and he drove out from Texas. He drove all the way out here with just his stuff in the car. And we didn't have a place to stay, we didn't have anything. No guarantee of money or anything like that. And we came out, we did the NFL Combine for the first time together. And that was my first time doing it on my own, you know, just me and Dylan. And we gave him the nickname Edge, because it's like everything he did, he just came through. He never complained, he just worked nonstop. And man, this company wouldn't even exist if it wasn't for Dylan, for real. So clap it up.
Yeah.
Just told me he's tired. Look at me, look at him.
See, we gotta talk to the camera. Tell them that all the backwards going on. One not even make sense. I don't know what I'm talking about backwards. I kinda am tired, I ain't gonna play.
Only people I want on my team is the ones that's gonna risk it all. The one that's gonna risk it all. If I know you're gonna risk it all, you're gonna ride till the wheels fall off. Cause even when it go down, I promise you're gonna come back up. So I promise you, I ain't gonna give up. And I know you ain't, cause you already risked it all. You know what I mean? So it's just like, we already have that team. You know what I mean? So that, I just think it's, that's all you need, man. That's all you need.
I'd rather struggle with it, just us, than add a piece to the team that doesn't have that mindset. Like, there's a culture. Drew risked it all. Katie risked it all. Todd risked it all. I risked it all. Like Dylan. Seriously. Everybody has a story.
Seriously.
And it's like, we now know, like, if you're not about that life, then I don't care how talented you are. It doesn't matter.
When you get exposed to something over and over and over again, then you start to be like, oh, that's normal. So like, if I'm with you and every time I'm with you, we start talking like positivity, you're gonna think that's normal and you're gonna start talking back to me, and then that's our relationship. And like, you just have to figure out how to dominate every relationship in that sense where you're like, I'm gonna be this, like, this whatever, energy source, like positive source, but you gotta understand that I need to get better, and if we're together right now, I still gotta get better, you know what I mean?
11.
Box 17-6. Amy 16-2.
We were taught you can become really rich and famous by being an actor, actress, or singer, rapper, NBA player, whatever, but nobody was like, yo, you can actually develop a business and become a millionaire the right way. And the pathway to do it is a lot different than I expected. It's about being grateful for whatever little that you have and cultivating, having the best relationships you can have, having as many good relationships as you can have, and really cultivating those relationships and being a true and honest person. Like, I didn't realize like that's what it took, and I didn't realize that it's really about budgeting your time, your energy, you know, removing yourself from circles that aren't benefiting you.
I went down the wrong path. I started hanging out with the wrong people and, you know, doing things I shouldn't have been doing, and all of a sudden I got in a car accident that broke my femur.
They said that my son had been airlifted to Washington Hospital and that I needed to get over there right away.
The doctors told her that I broke my femur and I wouldn't be able to run again.
The best that we had hoped for was that he would walk, but with a limp, but he would never be an athlete again. And I could just see this look in his eyes that was not gonna be his history.
I was pretty hard-headed growing up, so at first it was just like a reaction, like, no, I'm gonna prove everybody wrong. Once I got like one step further and, you know, got out of bed or, you know, started walking on the stroller, I was like, okay, wait, maybe this is possible. And in the process of learning how to walk and how to jog and how to run, I started to figure out, okay, there is another level, this is possible. Walked on to Temple, and the way that I did it is I walked in my coach's office with a black eye. I was like, hey, look, I've been boxing, I broke my femur, I've never run track before, but I want to try out. And he was like, absolutely not. There's no way, like, you have no experience doing this. Eventually he was like, you know what, Les, like, you're persistent, you're here every day, like, you could try out, but you're gonna have to run 4 miles consistent. As I got to the end of college, I started to kind of understand biomechanically, like, what my body needed to do or how I needed to train to get faster. And then after college is when it all kind of started coming into play.
Hey everybody, what's up? Chad Wesley Smith here, out here with Les Spellman, Spellman Performance, and he's gonna teach me how to run. And
so yeah, I got out of college and realized, like, I tried that, so what was I doing wrong? And that's where I really started, like, my study of biomechanics and understanding the body and starting to figure out, like, how alignment plays a certain tool and how strength plays a certain tool and how everything I was doing was right, but maybe it wasn't organized correctly, or maybe it wasn't progressed correctly, or maybe it wasn't detailed enough to get me to the goal. And I started I read everything, every article I could find, every, you know, every study I could find. And, you know, I'm still in that process, so this is, like, super humbling for me because I feel like I'm still on the way up and, like, understanding. And I've been lucky to have success, and, you know, I attribute that to, like, more communication and trying to figure out as I go. and realizing like 90% of the time I don't even have the full answer, but I'm gonna figure it out.
Everyone's great, everyone says thank you, everyone understands, but like, especially now, like looking at how some people in the world are living compared to how you're living and how grateful we are for the basic things like running water and food and even just access to chase your dreams. And there's times in my life that I had to look back to and remind myself where there was a barrier to my access to chasing my dream. Like there's things that I went through as a kid that prevented me from having the mindset that I have now. I find it really upsetting that people that have never even made their varsity basketball team are commenting on some of the best people in the world. And they're disappointed that they didn't push through mentally. It's like, that's ridiculous. I think Simone showed the most strength out of any athlete that I've ever seen to be at the top and not care about being embarrassed, not care about what people think about her, just decide this is what's best for me right now. It's a step away. And, you know, that takes a ton of strength because she knew she was going to be ridiculed for it. She knew she was going to take backlash, but she doesn't care. The real success, the real win isn't like this final destination that you're like everyone recognizes you for and so happy. Like the real win is like you actually being in the mindset to attack that, you know, like you deciding to wake up early, you deciding to have discipline on something. That's the real win.
You gotta be obsessed, bro. Like for real, like really obsessed and not really care anyone thinks. Like a year ago, or 2 years ago, we did this. People would have thought we were weird, bro. Like straight up. Like, why do y'all do that? Like, we normalized it because we kept putting it out there, kept putting it out there, kept putting it out there.
But we felt like this is something we should like do right now so that you have a very clear path. And I will get those estimates as soon as I can to you. In terms of
every sport, speed can take you to the next level.
Every sport.
And in so many sports, it is the limiting factor of how far you'll go.
Who can produce more horizontal force is going to win that 1 yard race.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it's the lowest hanging fruit in sports. And I think whoever grabs that is going to start to dominate just a little bit more.
Yep.
And then it's going to change a game. It's going to change every sport, every game.
Everything.
Four, pushing off one. You did this, and then your arms start counterbalancing. Okay. You start doing this when you're coming down the track until you finally get even. So a lot of people ask me, like, how do I spend my day? It's different. Like, growing up, I was very structured. Like, I only worked in, like, very, similar day set. Like, I would be very scheduled with my day. I'd do my homework at the same time, work out at the same time. Going into college, I knew, like, one of the few things that I had to do to be successful in college was number one is do my homework at the same time every day, do my workouts at the same time, just have the same routine. And then going into business, I struggled at first because in business there's no like huge accountability on you. Like there's nobody that's like, hey, do this, do that. It took me years to kind of get like a rhythm and a routine that really works for me. And right now it's pretty simple. So I'm a dad, number one, so I try to prioritize things in order. So being a good partner, having family first is kind of how I structure myself. So I try to first eliminate like distractions when I'm with my daughter or I'm trying to do something that's family oriented. And I try to schedule everything out. So I know like if I don't schedule it, then it won't happen. And I've also gotten really big into budgeting, like looking into how much money I'm spending and how my time is correlated with that. So what I do on Sundays is kind of lay out the week and say, here's how much money I can spend on food. Here's how much money I can spend on this and this and this. And I try to, manage that the right way, which is new. And I haven't been good at that in the past. And then I look at my time. I know that, I ask my girl and I say, okay, what day do you want to have us time? Or, when do you want to take Leilana somewhere? And I schedule that out. Now the rest of the time, I'm trying to work on business. Literally every other minute that I can outside of those categories. You're gonna strike here.
Yep.
Versus if you were flat, you'd strike here.
Right. Yeah.
So it's gonna change. It will tell you your velocity, mm-hmm. but your velocity on a curve, like
isn't the same as on the ground.
No doubt.
Yeah, because like Greedy could only hit 18 on that, but then he was hitting 22 on the ground.
Is it possible to have enough data points that you run people on the curve and in person, and you're able to tell how fast someone is on the curve on flat ground because you have so many, like if we did Greedy 100,000 times on the curve and 100,000 times on the field, you would know that 19.2 with these type of variables is 21.3 on the field.
Probably not because of
the strike.
Yeah, it depends on the strike. So like you naturally end up a little bit further out in front.
Mm-hmm.
What I do typically is I wake up around 5. I usually did 4:45 like for the past couple months, and now I'm right around like 5 o'clock. First thing I do is I get up, I put my feet on the ground, brush my teeth, and I just like start telling myself affirmations like, today's gonna be the day, today you're gonna conquer this, today, like I just start filling my brain with all positivity. And then the first part of my day I spend working out right after I leave. Everyone's out there drinking right now. Cinco de Mayo, Sunday, we're getting this working, trying to be great.
I'm just interested to know what's next for you. Yeah. You've gone from a small group, then the numbers have gone up, obviously for volume, then you've come down again for quality. What's next for you and the group and the team and the business? Where are you going?
Yeah, I think the next chapter is really helping more people. I'm the lowest hanging fruit, so we want to find a solution for athletes to all learn and not let price be a barrier. Had to walk a whole lot of miles to get here. It's safe to say that I'ma take the cake for this year. I would say try again next year, but next year will probably be my best year. It took a whole lot of blood and sweat tears. I don't owe anybody anything.